Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Kyle Stone, and I am a product marketing engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will take a closer look at input impedance and input bias currents. Input bias current, or IB, is directly related to input impedance. IB is a common electrical specification found in the datasheet of a typical current sense amplifier, or CSA for short. Whether the CSA is an analog current shunt monitor or a digital power monitor, in the electrical specifications table, there is at least one IB specified. As an example, in this datasheet, IB is specified under the default condition, namely VS equals 5 volts, VCM equals to 12 volts, VREF1 and VREF2 both equal to 2.5 volts, and VSense equals to 0 millivolts. Under this condition, the negative and positive input bias currents are typically both 90 microamps. To get a complete picture of how IB changes when the CSA is subject to conditions that are different from the default, we need to refer to the relevant curves in the typical characteristics section of the datasheet. In this particular datasheet, there are three IB curves. The graph on the left shows the relationship of IB versus input common mode voltage when supply voltage VS equals to 5 volts. The graph in the middle shows the relationship of IB versus input common mode voltage when supply voltage VS equals to 0 volts. The graph on the right shows the relationship of IB versus input differential voltage. Input impedance is directly related to input bias current. For this reason, it would be redundant to list this in the specification table in addition to IB. We'll now take a deep dive and inspect the typical IB curves. By the end of this video, we will be able to estimate the common mode and differential mode input impedances. Knowing the common mode and differential input impedances helps us understand their potential to impact the system that the CSA is used in. A typical current shunt monitor resembles a difference amplifier. At the same time, it is different in that the current shunt monitor is able to work off a low-level power supply, such as 2.7 volts or 5 volts. Yet, it is able to measure a high voltage bus supply, such as 80 volts. Have you ever wondered how it is possible to accomplish this? The magic lies in the input stage. In the input stage, the high voltage input signal is separated into common mode and differential model signals. The differential signal is level shifted for amplification, then the amplified version is passed to the input. The common mode voltage is compared with the supply voltage, and if it is higher, the common mode voltage is used to power the input stage directly. This is the reason behind the unique characteristics of these curves we see here. In the graph on the left, we can see a clear handoff when the common mode voltage transitions above or below the supply voltage of 5 volts. When the common mode voltage is lower than the supply voltage powers the amplifier and the current from the input is not needed. When the common mode voltage exceeds the supply, current is siphoned off to power the front end of the amplifier, therefore the jump in IB. In the graph on the right, there is no similar handoff. This is because the supply voltage is 0 volts. IB is continuously drawn to power the amplifier. To estimate the equivalent common mode input impedance, we can take any two points on the linear portion of the curve and calculate the slope. As shown, the equivalent impedances are slightly different. It should also be noted that the calculation is based on one input pin and therefore one input bias current. Considering there are two input pins from the perspective of the supply, the total IB draws double, and the equivalent common mode input impedance halves. When bus supply current passes through a shunt resistor, it forms the shunt voltage. It is this shunt voltage that a CSA extracts, amplifies, and presents through its output pin, hopefully without distortion. The shunt voltage is applied to the CSA input pins differentially. Shown here is a typical current sense amplifier block diagram. The common mode voltage sensing circuit is illustrated by a pair of resistors. An ideal current source indicates current is siphoned off to power the front end of the amplifier. When the shunt voltage is non-zero, the two IBs are no longer equal. This behavior is shown in the graph on the right. Similar to the common mode input impedance calculation, the differential input impedance can be estimated by measuring the slope of these curves with any two points. In this graph, the differential voltage reaches 1 volt. It should be noted that in normal applications, the shunt voltage is normally less than a few hundred millivolts. Otherwise, the CSA will run into swing limitations. This graph is plotted on an extended range in order to show the effect of the shunt voltage on IB. Another key takeaway is that the IB graph is symmetrical with respect to the y-axis. This is applicable to situations where the CSA is bidirectional and the shunt voltage can either be positive or negative. In some digital power monitors, the bus supply voltage is measured through either a dedicated V-bus input pin or through one of the shunt voltage input pins. In case number one, the device measures bus voltage through a dedicated V-bus pin. With a simple voltage divider, the high voltage V-bus is divided down to a low voltage signal that is within the range of the internal ADC. The total resistance of this divider is the equivalent input impedance of 830 kiloohms. In the second example, the device does not have a dedicated V-bus pin. Instead, the V-bus voltage is measured through input minus pin. In this particular device, the divider resistance is 320 kiloohms. The input bias current is therefore listed separately. The additional current in the in minus pin equals to bus voltage divided by 320 kiloohms. Simply add the resulting number to 20 microamps intrinsic value, and you'll get the total input bias current minus IB. In many circuits, it is an advantage to incorporate input filtering, whether it is to reduce input noise or designed as EMI filters in order to satisfy certain system-level regulatory requirements. A simple RC low-pass filter is effective in these situations. The effect on gain reduction due to external resistors may need to be considered. Generally, the magnitudes of IB and the resistors need to be evaluated. All other specs being equal, using a device with lower IB will simplify the design. This topic is discussed in a separate video. IB imposes a limit on the lowest current to be measured. In high side configuration, one input bias current flows through the shunt resistor and is indistinguishable from normal bus supply current. For this reason, The select CSA IB current must be smaller than the current it measures. In low side configuration, the IB effect is not as severe because IB decreases to almost zero. Current sense amplifiers work well when measuring low impedance sources, such as voltage power supplies. Some sources, such as certain sensors, have relatively high output impedance. When measuring this type of source, we should evaluate the impact of the CSA input impedance. For digital power monitors, a combination of low side shunt voltage sensing and external bus voltage divider can enable them to measure bus supply that exceeds the datasheet limit. However, the V bus pin input impedance must be considered in order to accurately account for the divider effect. More on this in the following slides. As pointed out before, the shunt voltage is typically on the order of a few tens of millivolts. Therefore, the difference between IB plus IB minus is generally neglectable. Let's look at an example to examine the effect of input impedance. Here we look at the digital power monitor V-bus pin. In this example, we want to measure a power supply rail of 80 volts. Since the INA233 input range is limited to 36 volts, we decide to divide the bus voltage down to 20 volts before passing it to the INA233. Considering the effect of input impedance but ignoring resistor tolerance, we can calculate the actual input voltage to be 19.645 volts, which represents a 1.78% deviation from the ideal 20 volts. While 1.78% is not bad, we paid for it with the price of burning 1 milliamp through the external divider. A better alternative is to use a device with higher input impedance, or better yet, a device that can take high input voltage directly. From time to time, we see designs where separate grounds are used for the bus supply and the current sense amplifier. Such an example is shown in the left side diagram. This practice provides no return path for the input bias currents. One symptom of such a design is a large periodic distortion or glitch on the output waveform. The correct solution is shown on the right side. Here, a single ground is used for the entire current sensing circuit. The ground is partitioned into different zones. During the placement and layout, one should arrange the zones so that they can be separated from each other, yet they are all connected at a single point, or the so-called start ground. In doing so, local current only circulates in the local ground plane and has a little negative impact on others. From time to time, we see designs where separate grounds are used for the bus supply and the current sense amplifier. Such an example is shown in the left side diagram. This practice provides no return path for the input bias currents. One symptom of such a design is a large periodic distortion or glitch on the output waveform. The correct solution is shown on the right side. Here, a single ground is used for the entire current sensing circuit. The ground is partitioned into different zones. During the placement and layout, one should arrange the zones so that they can be separated from each other, yet they are all connected at a single point, or the so-called start ground. In doing so, local current only circulates in the local ground plane and has a little negative impact on others. Let's take a minute to summarize what we learned in this video. Input impedance and bias current are related. Common mode and differential mode input impedances are finite. Current sense amplifiers pull some amount of current to power the input stage. Choose a low IB current sense amplifier in order to measure low current. Provide return path for IB. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.